sitting here with Joan Sheridan, and I just learned that that was a general in the Civil War. Are you related to him?
I am.
Oh, wow, that's great. So, you know, your ancestry goes pretty far back in America then.
Yes, and he is a character in American history for sure.
It's very cool. So you are from Heritage Spinning and Weaving. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Heritage Spinning and Weaving is a retail store in downtown Lake Orion, and it has been there since 2000. So this year we're celebrating 23 years, and we have classes for spinning, knitting, weaving, crochet, and we have all the tools and yarn for that.
Wow, so 23 years. Could you tell me a little bit about the history behind those 23 years? What was the origin like?
Well, I couldn't find the supplies that I needed, so I said, I might as well provide them. So we grew from one room to the full 3,000 square foot space. And we've built a really warm community of crafters in downtown Lake Orion.
I think people can really appreciate that, taking it upon yourself, being responsible, taking, you know, being responsible for the community individually rather than relying on, you know, other supplies. I think that's very great. So where do you guys meet?
Where do we meet?
Yeah.
At Knit Michigan?
In Knit Michigan, yeah.
Knit Michigan has, I started it in 2006 with another shop owner. And Knit Michigan serves cancer patients. And we provide a range of comfort items to hospitals around the state of Michigan. Hmm. And I am the founding director, but 2 years ago, I passed the reins on to the Yarn Stop, Sam and Mike at the Yarn Stop in Clawson, and now they meet there to make some of the items that we provide. Hmm.
And you call them comfort items. Can you take us through a little bit on these?
One of the things that happens when you have chemo is that you lose your hair. And people don't realize that it hurts. It hurts when your hair falls out. So not only does it physically hurt, but your sense of self is affected because you have no hair. Whether you're a man or a woman, it doesn't matter. And if it's a kid, it's even more important. So we make chemo caps out of very soft stuff. These are cotton and they can be thrown in the washer and the dryer. We make them for men, women, and children. And with two things that we really like, and one is that they're soft, and two is that they're attractive. So chemo caps, very useful. Hmm.
So yeah, that sounds great to me, because you know, hair is certainly a defining feature on everybody, and when you lose it, whether you shave your head willingly or, you know, whether you go through chemo, you know, you kind of look at yourself in a different way.
Yeah, you don't feel so well either, and you have a pallor in your skin that just says, I'm not healthy. So we try to make hats that are attractive and the right colors.
Hmm. Yeah, and you also feel cold without it too, so it kind of...
A lot of these hats are used for sleeping at night because the house is colder at night.
Yeah, it sure does get cold.
So, yeah, there's... lots of reasons that they provide comfort.
Hmm. And so how do you think the patients feel when they receive it and they go through, you know, using it?
Does it help them? Let me read this little thing. It says, Knit Michigan family, thank you for your kindness and generosity. My mom picked out a few beautiful hats from the basket at the cancer center. Her head got cold a lot, and your fun hats made her warm and feel cute. And that's it. We get notes all the time from people that two patients will work together and play with the hats and try them on and choose the ones that will make them happy. It's really important. Some of the other items, one of my favorite ones that we've had cool stories about is this lightweight blanket. Again, when your hair falls out, your hair doesn't just fall out on your head, it falls out on your body as well.
Right.
And your skin gets sensitive. So we make these lightweight blankets and give them out in the infusion therapy room. And one story was that a young man, like 12, got one and he fell in love with it, but he was all the way back down to the car and he realized that he left it in the infusion center. And they went all the way back up, even though he'd been in infusion for 3 hours, and got it because they're very comforting. One of the things that we do is every one of our products, it says comfort item handmade by, and then the individual's name, because this is a person-to-person thing. It takes a long time to add the trim to the blankets or knit the hat. And people need to know that a real person did it. It's all volunteer. We also have a variety of pillows. This one is
I can see you're very passionate about this.
No.
Yeah, and you're getting very emotional. It must be very fulfilling to do what you do.
It is. It makes a difference. And it's such an easy way. Like these pillows, they're super easy to make. Even a beginner can make them.
I can do this?
You could do this. We could have you making these in a couple hours. You'd be whipping them out. This one has a funny shape. It's not for your head. It's for under your arm. Hmm. When you have a mastectomy, they're tender in surgery scars, and this helps keep your arm from rubbing on the surgery site. So, important pillow that goes with, we told you we were going to talk about breasts.
Yes, and I told you that I'm very comfortable with this conversation.
So we make something called a knitted knocker, and they are to insert in your bra so that your clothes fit properly. You go from having something to having next to nothing, and your clothes may be lopsided or just not fit right. And these are an easy way. We give them to the patients with this little bag of fiber, the different sizes they can choose. It says on the tag what size it is. And then they can stuff it to the extent that they need to stuff it. And then they can take the fiber out when they need to wash it. Hmm. Medical prostheses are heavy and hot. And patients really like these.
Yeah, and you actually call them knitted knockers.
Knitted knockers.
Yeah, that's a very funny name.
But they can
yeah.
be crocheted as well. They don't just have to be knit. Mm-hmm. Let's see what else is here.
So you teach classes for this stuff too then?
Yes, sometimes. Mm-hmm. And our patterns are free on our website. You can stop in the store and you can get a free pattern and a free yarn. This one is for a crocheted hat.
Are the classes taught right there in the store?
We have events where they come in to take them, yes, right in the store. And there are 20 different collection centers around the state, so different collection centers have different events.
So it's different at every event. So like, what would an average typical event look like?
Well, once a month, people gather together to have a bag tag stuff sort party, and we send out boxes that are 18 inches square, and they are filled with a combination of all of these items. There are a couple other pillow sizes kinds here. Plus everything that I showed you, gets put in the box, and we send between 10 and 20 of them a month, which is really huge because everything that's made in them is made by a person at home on their own time, usually with their own dime, and it's sent out to help somebody that they'll never meet.
Hmm. I'd imagine they'd have just as much passion as you do working on this kind of thing here. So
we've all lost somebody or had cancer ourselves, and you want to help, and this is a good way.
It's beautiful. It's very beautiful. Yeah. A long time ago, when I would work for my church as a volunteer, we would knit blankets for the needy. So that was very helpful too. I felt very fulfilled doing that. So
it's an easy way to help somebody, and it's a good way. Mm-hmm. We called those prayer blankets. And just like those prayer blankets, you can knit prayers into these things.
Yeah, so you were talking about how you send, it says here you send 5 blankets, 10 hats, 6 pairs of knitted crocheted knockers, and 10 various pillows. So it's combined with all the events that you do have, and they're all different events, like you said, it sounds like a lot is getting out, a lot of output is happening because of this.
More and more. As the word gets out of what we do, our donations have increased every year. We've been doing this for 17 years. Hmm. So the more word gets out, and we send all the way across the state and all the way to the Keweenaw Peninsula.
Wow.
Yeah, huh. It truly is statewide.
Yeah, that's great. So where can people go to donate? Where can people go to reach Knit Michigan?
You can donate ready-made donate items that you've made at any of the collection centers, including my shop in Lake Orion. You can go to knitmichigan.org and find patterns, and you can also find a donation button. It costs about $20 to mail each box. By the time we pack it and buy the box and the postage. So there's always a need for money to support it. But it's an entirely volunteer organization, and anybody can help, and you don't need to have any crafting skills.
So what could you say to somebody who's feeling reluctant or hesitant to donate? How could you motivate them?
I don't think you have to look very far in your circle of friends to find somebody that has been affected by cancer. You may or may not even know it. And helping a friend, lending a hand, makes you feel good. And it's a selfish thing to do in some ways, because it does feel good to help others.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you've said some very powerful things here today. Is there anything else you'd like to say before we close up?
Visit knitmichigan.org. There is an event that we're advertising for May 6th that'll take place at the Yarn Stop in Clawson. And that's a way to donate and have fun and see what it's all about.
Okay, and they can find that on the Knit Michigan website or any social media
Yes.
that you're a part of? Okay. Well, thank you, Joan.
Thank you.
It was nice talking with you.